Hey everybody, my name is Dani and I'm here outside of the farm in Petaluma, and we have activists getting arrested, including Mexico founder Wayne Sean. He's inside of the van right now getting arrested. Other 50 activists, simply because they came to this farm because they wanted to help the animals. We have a legal right to rescue. The California Penal Code 597E says that if animals are not receiving food or water, we have the legal right to go inside and rescue animals that need that emergency medical care. Here we see activist Priya Sahani also getting arrested along with the 50 activists. So as you can see, we have dozens of activists standing outside to support the sacrifice that these people are doing. And earlier today, we saw police officers were grabbing the birds and putting them in vans, and they refused to help them. They refused to let the activists give them the emergency medical care that they needed. So right now, all we're doing is waiting. We're seeing our activists getting handcuffed simply because they wanted to help sick and injured, dying animals, which is the link online to please help us spread the message about what's going on. Please comment, like, and share this live stream so more people can see what the Petaluma authorities are doing to these activists. So let me show you. We have dozens of activists in support with white flowers in their hands and love in their hearts for everybody, for the chickens, for the workers, for the authorities, and for the activists. Yeah, so if you just joined this live stream, we've been here for a few hours now. We had activists going inside to provide emergency medical care to animals that were dying. And we had a team of people who were going to come outside, but the police officers blocked them and didn't allow them to come out to give this birds this emergency medical care that they needed. Instead, they arrested every single one of them who went inside of this facility simply because they wanted to help them. In this farm, you can supplies Amazon, supplies the Amazon cruelty that you can buy. Paul, do you have anything that you would like to say?
You know, I'm sure it's been said. Let's get over here and let's look at these activists being arrested right now.
Yep, so we're gonna move and show you the activists getting arrested. Excuse me, everybody. Excuse me.
Do you have Korea's mom's number?
I have everybody's contact information. So if you're wondering what's something that you can do, please like, comment, and share this live stream as we have activists coming out, getting arrested, simply because they wanted to provide emergency medical care to the animals that are inside of this facility. Right now we have a friend and activist, Rachel Ziegler, coming outside, getting arrested. I think she has a bird on her hands.
I'll call Danielle.
Rob. We have us here supporting, who are helping us get everybody's name so that we can, of course, give them the legal support.
Put the camera on Rachel. See Rachel?
Rachel, where's Rachel coming? I don't see Rachel.
She's behind that car.
Yeah, but Rachel? Okay. Hey folks, so it seems like we're going to the other side so that I can show you our activist right now. Okay, I'm not going to run. Our activist who's coming out with a bird getting arrested.
Never turning back. Never turning back. Never turning back.
So they just ripped a bird out of Rachel's hands. A sick and injured bird. As you can see, our friend Rachel Ziegler is crying right now.
Yeah.
Okay, she just tried to save someone's life.
So our friend Rachel Ziegler right now is crying because the police officer ripped someone off their seat. Our activist Rachel, who was simply trying to help an injured animal, and that animal was ripped off from her hands. And now she's being arrested. And if you're asking, you're wondering what's something that you can do, please like, comment, and share this live stream so everybody can see what's going on right now.
They're still taking another bird.
They're taking another bird. So as you can see, this police officer has a bird on their hands.
Stay on the birds, please.
Move behind the
So the police are ripping birds out of the hands of activists who came to save the birds. They're putting him in this animal care vehicle. This little individual should be going to a vet right now. And instead, they're being thrown into box with other dead birds, right where we try to rescue them from. The police are ripping birds out of the hands of activists.
Don't miss any of that.
But keep on growing stronger.
Hey, we have dozens of activists supporting the people who are getting arrested outside of this facility, singing songs of liberation, showing them support and showing love for the workers, for the authorities, and for the animals who are not going to be able to be saved today, who are going to be killed because we live in a world where animals are considered property.
There's another chicken coming out.
There's another chicken coming out, apparently.
On the left side,
as you can see, okay, we can see that officer has a bird on their hands. We see that Petaluma does not want to help animals. Petaluma officers are helping this farm exploit and kill animals.
Never turn him back.
So we have more activists coming out. We calculate that we have over 15 activists. They just took another bird from an activist. They're coming out. And we see that all those activists were simply trying to help these individuals who were injured, were sick, didn't have access to food or water. If you were in the live stream before, you saw that activists were providing these animals food and water, the food and water that they needed. But please share what's going on and use the hashtag Amazon Mass Rescue.
We should find out where they're going.
And yeah, we definitely need to find out where these birds are going. But for now, we know that they're not being helped because that's what we came here for. We came here to help these animals. We don't talk to the police. We have somebody who will talk to the police. Can you share about the neighbor? I don't think I know that story.
So we're not going to reveal. He doesn't want his identity revealed for understandable reasons. We have a next door neighbor lives right next door here. He's lived here. He says in 8 years, he's never once seen chickens outside until today. The animal rights activists show up. Suddenly, their chickens are all outside.
And this guy's
afraid to speak up publicly, but he's said that to me anonymously, and he's also agreed to anonymously speak to media on this.
Wow. Okay, so I'm going to be showing you guys the birds. And if you also want to support these activists, I'm going to be bailing everybody out. And right now we have an incredible opportunity that if you become a monthly member for $5 a month, which is as much as a coffee, you gain DXC an extra $100. And we're definitely going to need a lot of money to get this activist out. These activists are sacrificing their freedom to help these individuals. So if you think that you can do that, please become a member today. You can do that all the way until tomorrow, and that's going to be extremely helpful to help this activist. So we see we have another activist coming out right now. So they're all being loaded into this van, and if you just joined the live stream and you're wondering what's going on, we had an action at a farm in Petaluma that supplies Amazon, and we had a lot of activists going inside hoping to give them emergency medical care and bring some, if needed, bring some animals to sanctuary. But the authorities did not want that to happen. The authorities did not help these birds, and instead they arrested the activists because that's kind of like what's going on. Our society sees animals as objects, as property, and we live in a world that sees these individuals as property. They're not gonna get the emergency medical care that they need. They're not gonna need the help. They're not gonna get the help that they need. So if you're wondering what you can do from far away is please like, comment, and share this live stream so more people can see what's going on right now in Petaluma. And then also if you can become a member of the DXC Open Rescue Network, because for $5 a month you can help us gain an extra $100.
Hey sir,
let's see what's going on here.
She's an employee for a farm animal sanctuary, and I'm not sure what folks have in mind for those birds, but we would propose that we could offer we could transfer them, and they could be cared for.
What's
that? I don't know where they're nesting for their.
Oh, here I said call animal control.
Okay. Ryan, can you talk to animal control?
Uh-huh.
I have no idea what they're doing with them.
Okay, folks, so I was just told by somebody from inside that right now we can call the Petaluma Animal Control. So I'm going to see if I can get somebody to get that number for me and say, tell everybody, all of you, that number so that you can help us out. But let's see the interaction. So what just happened,
Matt? Is it possible to talk to him?
So, well, that was... There's a city police officer, so he's not in his jurisdiction, but we do want to try to talk to the county folks. So we've talked to Zoe, who's an organizer with the Slow Chapter, and Emily here, who works for Happy Hen Animal Sanctuary, and we're going to see if we can talk to them and get the chickens released to custody to be cared for at Happy Hen. Because frankly, we don't have much confidence in what animal control, you know, what they're gonna, they've already shown pretty wanton disregard for these chickens' lives.
Hey, Matt. So we were just told by Elmira, who's inside, that we need to call the animal control to ask them to take action for these animals.
Yes.
So you think that you can go and pin that on this live stream so that
yes.
people know?
I will do that. And I think what we want is say release these animals. It's not going to cost them any money. It's just going to be, you know, some paperwork or whatever. Release them to care at Happy Hen Animal Sanctuary.
Yeah.
That's our ask. So,
and I see a lot of these activists, or a few of these activists, are crying right now. And the reason is because it is frustrating to see that the authorities are not willing to help these sick and dying individuals.
Just loading them into those white vans. If you just joined the live stream,
those white vans are loaded with individuals who felt pain, who suffered, who their entire lives had no access to the outdoors, who their entire lives were exploited simply because they were born another species.
Yeah, no, I think we need to try to talk to it.
So all the activists are being loaded into these vans,
Zoe said she's
going to
call animal control.
We're going to be figuring out where they're going to be going, and we're going to be providing legal support for all of them. But thank you so much, everybody who's been following this action this far. If you're wondering how you can help, again, please like, comment, and share, so more people can know what's going on right now in Petaluma, California.
Which
jail?
Well, this is sheriff, but I think we want folks calling animal control.
Okay.
Not sheriff right now.
Yeah, I understand. I just.
Oh yeah. We're gonna pin it here momentarily.
Okay, folks, so we are gonna pin the number of the animal control, and we need all of you right now, all hundreds of you who are watching this live stream, to please call animal control.
Yeah, and I can tell you number two, it's 707-293-3157, and we're asking that they release the chickens to care of Happy Hen Animal Sanctuary.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and you'll probably, if they don't answer, just leave a message and say what's going on and ask them to help these birds. Because these birds are dying, they didn't have access to the outdoors, they didn't have food, they didn't have water, and they were living miserable lives. And all we're asking for is love and compassion. All we want to do is transform places of violence. With love and compassion, we want justice for all. So activists are continuing to get arrested, as we can see. We estimate over 50 activists probably getting arrested right now, sacrificing their freedom to help animals. And we even have a helicopter flying above us. We have dozens of activists with flowers in their hands and love in their hearts to support these activists.
I mean the amount of funds that are invested. You look at this bus, you look at, what is it, 10 plus police vehicles out here, however many employees are out here, a helicopter in the sky, the amount of funds that they're expending to try to prevent people from frankly enforcing the law. So literally, this is the amount that law enforcement is spending to avoid enforcing the law.
Thanks, Matt. So I'm just gonna continue to show you all. We have so many officers here, so many cops protecting this farm.
Matt?
Hi.
So, will you take his camera?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay,
great. So if you're wondering what just happened, I think the police officers are gonna give us the camera from the activists that we're documenting the conditions of the inside of this farm. We see our activists are still coming out right now. It's Tanya. I can take that.
There you go.
Thank you so much.
Okay, so I'm assuming he's telling you about Michael Goldberg. He's diabetic. He was one of those just arrested very sneakily. He needs to eat every so often. Like, please take that very seriously, because I've heard more stories from other police departments elsewhere.
Meeting's not always right, buddy.
the media's not always
good. I know.
We're going to do our best. Everybody's been peaceful to us. We're going to be peaceful to you. We're going to do everything we can to get everybody gone and through. That's why we're giving this property to people so we can expedite.
Thank you.
Do you know, what entity is this? The animal, is it Sonoma County Animal Control? The vehicle?
I tell you,
but I mean,
there is animal control out here. I don't know who you're pointing at.
Oh, but this white truck, is that y'all? Is that Sonoma County?
Okay, folks, so we just found out that Animal Control is here at the facility, and they are the ones who are grabbing this bird from the activist, and they're loading them into that white truck. So all of you right now to take action. Please call Animal Control and ask them to release those birds to the activists. We can take them to a sanctuary and give them the lives that they deserve. But we cannot do that without you. Please call Animal Control.
Sonoma
we linked
County.
It on this live stream, the Sonoma County Animal Control.
This big heavy duty one. Yes.
And we have activists singing songs here to show love and support for the animals, for the activists, and for everybody who came out here today to support this effort of animal rescue.
I sing my voice against this war, so powerless.
So we see Michael Goldberg getting arrested. And if you don't know Michael, one of our photographers, if you've seen our pictures, he's usually the one taking them. So now he just got arrested. Are you, Matt,
where'd he go?
So they're giving us all the gear that these activists were using to document the conditions inside of this facility.
This is, I have six cameras. Oh, Jake. Oh, Michael. Okay.
Michael's
okay,
it's
Michael.
Okay, good.
So,
he's the one who's diabetic, so make sure that.
Okay.
And if you're wondering how you can help, there's many ways that you can help us spread this message right now. You can engage on this live stream, comment, like, and share, and use the hashtag Amazon Mass Rescue, and let people know that the authorities of Petaluma are arresting activists simply because they were trying to help animals. You can also call the animal control services and ask them to please release those birds to sanctuary because we can give them the life that they deserve, the life that all animals deserve. So please do those things right now, and if you can, please comment once you share the live stream so that other people can do the same. Is there any questions on the live stream for us? Let me know if there's any questions on the live stream that I can answer. And while we answer those questions, we can also show you what's going on. That's where the activists are being put after they get arrested, in that van. And in that white truck, there's live birds, who we don't know what's going to happen to them yet.
They used to laugh, but soon they'll start to join us. Warriors, we will train our minds to fight with love and only fight. Forgiveness and the endless
sacrifice. And please call Sonoma Animal Control and ask them to release all those birds to us because we can put them in a sanctuary and give them the lives that they deserve. But we need to call them so that they know that we need to take action. Please call the Sonoma County Animal Control Services and ask them to release the birds that they currently loaded in this white truck. So somebody asked when they are going to jail. They're going to jail right now. So I think they're just waiting to load this van and they're all gonna be taken to jail. But with the help of all everybody here, the activists, all the support that we've received, they're gonna be receiving jail support. I'm personally gonna make sure that these activists are okay. Unfortunately, right now I cannot say the same about those birds who are loaded in that white truck. We don't know what's gonna happen to them. All we know is that they're sick, that they're thirsty, that they're starving, and that they're probably going to die.
But you can take action. You can call right now Animal Control Services and ask them to release those birds to us, because we can take them to sanctuary. Do you have anything to add on the live stream, Paul?
Yeah, just thank you so much to everybody who's calling in. My mom called me. She said, I'm calling. So many birds are in that truck right now. We have homes for them. Please politely talk to Sonoma County Animal Control and say, hey, we have a vet, we have a sanctuary, we have placement. Please relinquish the birds to us. We'll make sure that they get the best veterinary care and that they're well taken care of, and we'll take that burden off of Sonoma County to have to deal with them. So, you know, we're not mad at Sonoma County Animal Control. You know, they're at least they didn't just give them back to the farmer. They could see that, yes, these birds are in need of care. So we're trying to do that. This is a lot of effort. So many people are working so hard today. So far, we've only saved one life. It's worth it to save one life for all of this. One little bird who lived in this hellhole for all their life and was about to get shipped over across the state, hung upside down by their legs, electrocuted, have their neck slit and sold as an object, will instead get to live their life out in a most beautiful place on earth, an animal sanctuary. And so we appreciate your support so much for all of that. And other than that, yeah, please stay tuned. Please help out. If you want to support this work that's happening, you can go to dxe.io/member and become a supporting member. This is a movement not funded by money, but funded by love and funded by effort. At the same time, there's bail to be paid. There's gas, there's vehicles, there's cost, there's animal care. It adds up really fast. If you go to dxe.io/member, you can become a $5 monthly supporter, and for the next couple days we'll get a $100 bonus for that. It means the world if you could do that. Other than that, just thank you all so much for tuning in. Thanks for watching. Stay with us. There's got to be close to 60 activists being arrested right now. Spread this around. Let them know that, like, hey, this is who Amazon is doing business with. This is Jeff Bezos is doing business with a farm that would go so far to keep birds inside their entire life over and over until finally they heard we're coming, and then put them out in the sunlight for show, according to their neighbor. It's not acceptable, but yeah, look at Michael Leonis here. It's about to be loaded on along with Ronnie Rose. This is a videographer. Rose. This is someone, Ronnie, who's documenting what's happening, and they're being arrested for it. This is not something that Ronnie should be arrested for. This is something Ronnie should be appreciated for.
Yes. And along the activists, I see my friend Rachel, who actually lives with chickens. She is a sanctuary operator. Those chickens the life that they deserve.
Careful,
and
everybody.
I'm really happy to see that she's also taking action for animals. Yeah. We have her mom here. Would you like to say anything about how you feel about your daughter right now being arrested simply because she was trying to help animals?
I understand her feelings. I'm very proud of her. She's courageous. I'm proud of my daughter's courage and my daughter's ethics, her morals. She knows what chicks to say.
We're gonna pull this bus full of activists out right now.
That the birds that are being rescued have massive bodies. They're 6 weeks old, but really, some of the chicks that we rescued who haven't been bred to be killed for their meat are tiny. These are really just baby birds, and Rachel knows this intimately because she lives with our birds. Very proud of my daughter.
Yeah, we're all very proud of all these activists who are taking action for animals while helping them out. Like, all they did was come here and try to give them food, try to give them water, and try to take them to sanctuary. And I don't know if you know, but right now there's birds loaded in a white truck, and we don't know what's going to happen with them. That is the animal control. And we're asking people to call animals. Thank you so much for doing everything, for helping us out, and for talking with me. So in that truck is where all the activists are being loaded, every single one that has gotten arrested so far today. If you just tuned in right now and you're wondering what's going on, so we were doing an action at a farm in Petaluma that supplies Amazon. And if you don't know, we have an ongoing campaign against Amazon because they are leading in abusing and killing animals simply because of profit. Like, their CEO and co-founder Jeff Bezos is the richest person on the planet, and at the same time so many people are suffering because of that. He is making money, profiting, making billions of the exploitation of animals. So yeah, we're out here, and we had activists going inside of this facility because they wanted to document the conditions
we had proof that there was criminal animal cruelty happening, and we wanted to give them food, we wanted to give them water, we wanted to give them the emergency medical care that they needed. And if we saw animals that were about to die, we wanted to take them to sanctuary. But unfortunately, that didn't happen. We were only able to rescue one animal, but to that one animal, that meant the world. To that one animal, their life has changed forever. They're on their way right now to the sanctuary, and they're gonna live hopefully the life that they deserve. But everybody else who was inside was not able to let it come out, so those activists were arrested. So that's kind of like what's going on right now. You can see in this van, that's where all these activists were loaded after being put in handcuffs, simply because they were trying to do the right thing. They were trying to uphold the law. If you don't know, the California Penal Code 597E says that if animals don't have access to food or water, we have the right to go inside and provide those food and water for those animals.
I'm going to back you guys up because he's going to pull out.
So I'm being asked to back out. So right now I cannot show you any closer what's going on.
We don't want anybody to get run over.
But yeah, we have dozens of activists with white flowers on their hands and love in their hearts for everybody. If you don't know, we are a nonviolent group. We're nonviolent in actions, in words, in tone. So we didn't come here to target any individuals. We didn't come here to target the workers of this farm. We didn't come here to target the police officers. We're here to target the system. The system that allows violence towards animals to exist. Okay, folks, so right now the van is leaving. The activists that went inside of this facility are being taken to jail. So please like, comment, and share this live stream so that we can share with the world what's happening. So we have activists just holding peace signs to show that we are a movement of love, that we're a movement of compassion, and that, like I said, we're not target any individuals. We were not here to target any of the workers. We understand that they're all still wrapped on this system that allows violence towards animals to exist. So I'm gonna check if there's any questions on the live stream right now. So Tina asked what happened to the birds they were trying to save. So we were able to save one bird, and now that bird is on their way to the sanctuary. Now that individual is gonna live the life that she deserves. But all the other birds were taken, ripped off from the activists' arms who were trying to take them to medical care, and loaded into that white truck that you can see right there. That is the animal control who took the birds off the activists' hands, and we don't know where those birds are going. We don't know what's gonna happen to those birds. That is asking you to call animal control so that those birds can be released to us, because we have placement for them. Right now we can take them to a sanctuary, right now we can take them to a veterinary that can help them, that can give them the food that they need, the water that they need, the medical care that they need. But all that we are asking is to please, animal control, please release those animals to us. Are they gonna be killed anyways? So we have activists here holding white flowers, showing love, showing compassion for everybody.
Animal liberation!
Animal liberation!
Go vegan! So, we had so many activists arrested today that it seemed like they didn't fit all in one van, because I still see activists who have not been loaded into a van. Would you like to say something on the live stream, Andrew?
I have to call someone, I'm sorry.
Okay. If you just joined this live stream, activists were arrested because they were inside of a Petaluma farm that supplies Amazon. And these activists were simply trying to give emergency medical care to the birds, the individuals that live at this facility. And instead, they were arrested and the birds were ripped off their arms and they were loaded in a white truck. That it's right in front of us. So if everybody could please see, that white truck is full of live birds that need emergency medical care. Every single individual inside of that white truck right now is sick,
They're dying. They need food. They need water. They're suffering. And they are not receiving that medical care because we live in a world where animals are considered property.
But that is why we take action for them. That is why we come out, we speak up for them, and we sacrifice our freedom to do the right thing.
So yeah, I'm just going to continue showing everybody what's happening. More activists are still coming out. And please, please comment, like, and share this live stream so more people can see what's happening right now in Petaluma. There are more activists going there. We have, we still have activists in there.
Monica?
Monica? All right. Thank you.
We'll get it eventually. Thanks, Orlando.
Okay. Yep, we still have more people coming out. We estimate that probably close to 60 activists are getting arrested today. They're putting a lot of stuff in the Just look, okay, folks, look how many police cops we have here. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I don't know, the line is really big. It's just so interesting to see how much money they're spending to harass these activists instead of using those funds to help these animals.
As of right now, I think, I don't know if there's somebody we might be missing, but at least 52 arrests.
Including those people there?
We counted, yeah.
Okay, so right now 52 people have been arrested.
Actually, I can see. Yeah, it's gonna end up being maybe 55.
That includes 55
non-violent activists have been arrested at this Petaluma facility. All they were doing was trying to give them the emergency medical care that they needed.
So let me show you. And if you're wondering what you can do to help, please engage on this live stream. You can like, comment, and share so more people can see what's going on. And also, please, we're asking you to call the animal control services because as I speak, those birds inside of that white truck may be dying. So if you don't know what happened, the officers ripped off birds of the activists' arms and loaded them into that white truck. I don't know if Paul has anything to say right now.
Yeah, I was just gonna trade off temporarily so you can get started with your task of jail support, frankly.
Okay, so. Can I have my phone, please?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm gonna pass the live stream to Paul, who's also an organizer with DXC. And if you don't know right now, what I'm going to do is legal support. In DXC, we have a direct action team that all we do is prepare for these actions. All we do is provide legal support for the folks who just risk their freedom. And you can also help me out because this is gonna cost a lot of money. We have 55 people so far that have been arrested, and I'm gonna bail every single person out. So if you can, please become a member. You can become a member by going to dxc.io/member. And as little as $5 a month, that's a cup of coffee, you can gain DXC an extra $100. And with that money, we're going to provide legal support for all these activists who just risked their freedom, who just right now were taken to jail. So I am going to start right now with legal support. So I'll leave you with Paul.
Hey, everybody. Thanks for staying with us. We're going to keep an eye on what's happening here. We're prepared to follow the Sonoma County Animal Control Vehicle, so we make sure we know where the birds go. So we definitely hope that the county will relinquish the birds to us so we can take them to the sanctuary. And in the meantime, let's see if we can just talk to some activists and see what they're thinking. Hey Nick, what are your thoughts on today?
I feel like it's a lot of unnecessary violence. Basically, I mean, if you imagine yourself in cramped in an enclosure in a small room, never to see the light of day, how would you feel? If you've seen a dog or a cat, would you save them? Would you go and bring them food? Would you bring them water? If it was a child, a woman, a man, you wouldn't hesitate. These are all lives. These are all living creatures, living beings that deserve the same food, the same water. Just simple health care. And here we have them. Not relinquishing them to us to bring them the proper care, the proper housing for them to be free. And instead, they are going to be thousands more to be enslaved and become nothing more than a product.
You said it all, Nick. Nick's someone who dedicates a lot of time and energy. You build structures for animals on sanctuaries, do a lot of volunteering. Anyone watching the live stream, if you haven't had a chance to go to sanctuaries to meet chickens and pigs and cows and other animals, you got to get there. You got to meet these beautiful individuals, see that they're just like us in all the ways that matter. But yeah, Nick said it best. We're just acting in accordance with, I think, you know, just about everyone's values. We don't think anyone should be suffering, and we definitely have so much suffering and misery here on the farm right now. So here come the police with some more bags. Here come some more birds. So that was probably a bag of dead birds. I was on the earpiece. So I'm assuming that that's biosecurity gear in the bags that the police have. They're going to be taking a lot of stuff into evidence, and we're going to be getting it back hopefully tomorrow. But yeah, this is a sad moment. It's a sad moment. It's also an encouraging moment to see that people care so much to come and to be part of this. And if anyone thinks that anything is going to stop us from you know, exerting our right to rescue animals, then they're sorely mistaken. We're going to keep doing this until everyone's free, until it's the normal thing to do, until we live in a world where it's not okay to exploit anyone, it's not okay to hurt anyone. So it looks like we've got a couple activists still left.
I'm going to do a quick debrief here.
Okay. So Tanya's going to debrief and we're going to watch that.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Okay, so can everybody hear me?
Yes.
Okay, let's try to do a little circle here so that we can have a quick debrief about what just happened.
Thank you.
So activists are still getting arrested right now. We're going to come here and do a quick debrief about what just happened and what's coming up next.
You want us on this side of the road, or?
Yeah, so let's try not to block this road here, but just like do a little circle.
So we'll go down there.
Yeah, and you can also be here too.
Yeah.
Come out.
Yeah.
Well, first of all, I wanted to say thank you all so much for coming out today. It's been a long day. It's been a long action for all of you. I know that there's a lot of emotions going on right now, probably, and I'm just going to give everybody a little bit of a brief of what happened. So everybody who went inside got arrested, and simply because they were trying to help individuals inside of that facility that supplies Amazon. And this action was a way to end our occupation, our week-long occupation of Whole Foods. And this farm is supplied to Amazon, which is owned by Whole Foods. So now we were able to save one life. So for that one individual, their life has completely changed forever. They're now on their way to a sanctuary, and they will be receiving the medical care that they need. And I think Susanna was the one who carried that individual to freedom. So thank you so much, Susanna.
Thank you.
I think Susanna mentioned that bird had two broken legs. Is that correct? Would you like to share a little bit with people about what happened?
They told us we could only bring the bird who was the most injured out. And unfortunately, that poor bird, both her legs were broken, so she could not reach food or water. And so it was essential that she get food and medical help immediately, else she would have perished. And I can't tell you, like, feeling her heart beating against mine as I carried her out, like, I am willing to do anything to protect these animals, and I am so glad that we are all here today. And even if one life was saved, that one life means everything. So thank you so much.
Good job, Susanna.
Thank you so much, Susanna. And if you don't know, Animal Control came, and that white truck right there is loaded with live birds who are sick, who are dying, who are probably thirsty, scared, and all simply because those activists who got arrested, they were carrying them to freedom. And the officers ripped them off their activist hands and put them inside of that truck. So right now, we're asking people on the live stream to call animal control to ask them to release those birds to us, because we have placement for them. We can take them to a sanctuary. We can leave, give them the life that all animals deserve. So after this action, if you like, you can also call animal control, and we're going to be seeing how that goes. And with the activists, I am going to be doing legal support. I am going to, right now, pretty much after this action, I'm going to go to jail. And I'm going to stay there and bail people out until every single one of them is out. So if people are interested in helping, like especially people who have cars, because we need to drive people to their homes. So I will probably need like 5 people if you're able to have a car. It is an intense job because you can be up all night, but just you can come back to me after. And then also we're going to be arranging carpool. So a lot of the people who drove here got arrested today. So we're going to be rearranging the way the cars work, but we're all going to drive back to Berkeley. And we're gonna have a little get together, I think, still, or maybe not.
I don't know. I think we might. We'll see.
We'll see that, because I have to legal support at least. So I think that's a priority right now. And I don't know, Chris, did you have anything else to add?
Yeah, I'm really grateful to everyone who came and helped move cars at the last minute. And I also did not get all of the keys back. So, does anyone have keys that you moved the car for? If you could bring them back just so we could have them all.
This came from in the farm, actually, but
okay.
I might as well start a collection.
We did get a lot of cars moved out, and we are going to need some help. Some people will help Tanya with jail support if they like. And we'll need other people to drive cars to Berkeley that they did not maybe drive here. So if you can help drive cars, I'm going to want you to come to me. But we're going to have to understand that this may take a few minutes to figure out. This isn't like a very simple, straightforward process.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Chris. So maybe we can get everybody who's willing to drive a car back to Berkeley behind Chris.
Can I just say
And Matt would like to add something before that happens.
Hey everybody, just a couple quick things. I've been doing the press work around this, and we've already secured coverage in Forbes. We've already secured coverage in The Guardian, and that was before all these arrests happened. So I know like maybe people aren't feeling so great about this, but I'm on the ground talking to media, and this is the complete outrage, and they feel the same way we do right now. So, I don't know what, like last time, for example, we had that incredible coverage from Democracy Now! With Glenn Greenwald, a 9-minute piece that sprung up out of nowhere. So I think, you know, we're probably looking at something like that or even more, because, I mean, this is just beyond, So we'll see. Good job, everybody.
So, yeah, and to clarify, we will, some of us will be doing jail support. Some of us will be following the animal control vehicle to wherever it goes, so we know for sure where the birds are. Some of us will be staying there, having a vigil for those birds, making sure that they get, you know, released to us, not euthanized. And that what we want to do is remember that today we have an opportunity to use today as a springboard to move forward. Like Matt mentioned, people are going to be reading about this, seeing that it's outrageous that like all these officers have better things to do. Everybody here has better things to do, but there is an injustice taking place. There are animals who are trapped inside these walls, suffering to no end, and nobody feels good about it. The neighbor across the street said it's disgusting. People down the road said, yeah, it's really sad. Nobody feels good about this. It's just what's happening now. It just takes a group of people to decide, like Susanna, I'm going to do whatever it takes to change this. Whether that means risking my freedom, whether that means spending my whole weekend getting people out of jail, supporting people, doing vigils all over the area, flying from Phoenix to be here for this. Coming to the Animal Liberation Western Convergence in Utah. You all think that this was an important day? It was. Please, 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 everyone on the live stream, everyone here, come to the Animal Liberation Western Convergence.
Yeah.
I'm facing 60 years in prison. 70 years in prison. Thanks, Tanya. Yeah, and that's not likely. But there's definitely a chance I'll go to jail for 10, 20 years, a couple years. I don't know. But that's not something that anybody thinks is okay. People say, what are you going to jail for 10 years for? Oh, for rescuing sick animals. People are outraged. So we need to capitalize on this by getting people, mobilizing our friends, our families, people who aren't even thinking about animal rights. Say, hey, come to Utah. We do a lot of stuff here in California where animal rights activists are prevalent, social justice activists are prevalent. And in the state of Utah, it's the industry is prevalent. That's where Smithfield, the largest factory farm, one of the largest factory farms on the planet, is located. And we want to go right there. We want to go there and bring this same energy and to make the same demands to let the animals out, to make sure the animals get care. And it's up to us, it's up to you watching at home to do it. We can do it. I promise you, we can change this world. We got it. We got this. We got this. Let's do it. All right. Yeah, good point. So the conference is November 16th through the 21st. That runs from like a Friday until like a Tuesday. But really, Sunday and Monday, those would be the big days you really want to get there. Get there for Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. But like Sunday and Monday, we'll be doing really important trainings, taking very bold action for animals, and getting even more news, getting this story out there, because everybody who hears about this is on our side. So everybody who hears about it is on our side. And like Chase said, go to dxc.io/ALWC. You can register, encourage your friends. Anybody who's not even, you know, if someone's got a dog or a cat at home, they are on this team. We really want them there with us. Friends who live around Utah, bring them. Everybody in Utah is amazing. Everybody hears what's happening and they're like, wow, that's unbelievable. I support you. There's so much support for this. It's just up to us to pull it together. So thank y'all so much. Okay, so Leo.
I think they left.
Okay, so all right. So listen, we're going to follow this vehicle. This is the animal control vehicle. We're going to get the vehicle. We have a vehicle designated to follow it, and we're going to make sure it goes well. Okay, so I don't know. What's up?
We can just start coordinating carpools at this point.
Okay, we're going to start coordinating. Do you want to shut the live stream down? Or?
Yeah, we can. Thank you so much, everybody, for joining us live during this action. Please like, comment, and share, and also call Animal Control to ask them to release those birds to us, because we can put them in a sanctuary and we can give those birds the lives that they deserve. So for now, we're going to leave, but we're going to be updating you soon on what's going on with those activists. Thank you all.
Yeah, and the car is right now leaving, right behind the Animal Control vehicle, and we're going to update y'all through the page, through this post. We'll let you know what's going on and find out what happens to these birds. These birds need help. Let's get them out of animal control. We'll call Petaluma County Animal Control, say, hey, relinquish the birds to us. We have homes. We have vets. We'll take care of them. Let's see if we can instead of saving just one life, let's see if we can save a dozen and then turn that to a million.
Okay. All right. Awesome.